Have you ever wondered why people feel sleepy in the middle of the afternoon but are quite alert around 10 in the morning? This is due to the circadian rhythm that guides our organism throughout the day. This clock is naturally occurring and is built into the human organism but also in other species such as fish or plants. In fact, most species on Earth possess this biological system that keeps the body in sync with the cycles of day and night. There are several criteria that a biological circadian rhythm must follow. It has to last approximately 24 hours, and it can be reset by exposure to light. But what happens during this 24-hour cycle? In the mammalian circadian clock, the transcription factor called clock dimerizes with another transcription factor called BMR1. The clock BMR1 dimer promotes the transcription of the cry and purr genes. After transcript of purr and cry are translated in the cytosol, the protein dimerize, return to the nucleus, and interact with the clock BMR1 complex. This interaction inhibits the ability of clock and BMR1 to activate the transcription of the purr and cry genes, stopping new transcripts that encode for purr and cry. As purr and cry proteins degrade, clock and BMR1 are free to promote purr and cry transcription again. The cycle starts again, forming the negative feedback loop that generates the 24-hour cycle, that is the circadian rhythm. Recently, chronic disruption of the circadian rhythm has been shown to cause fatigue, insomnia, and is at times linked to obesity, diabetes, and even cancer. This is why it is important to properly understand and take care of our internal clock, that is the circadian oscillator.